to retain some kind of self-control. Look inside my head through a telescope. You erase all the calls from a telephone. No sense of smile, maybe tell a joke. Holding back your tears, singing minimal syllables. Yeah. Look at me, at the asylum. Was a fate or mistake, cause the time ain't up. Yet the parts of my mind don't get much love. If you want in my head, come and call me up. You look like a twisted Robin Hood. Yeah, you take from the rich and the poor and us. Wearing diamond shoes where you walk your pugs. In a time you create where there ain't no love.
Where do I go?
It is always a celebration here in New Orleans, and we are just outside of the French Quarter at the Mercedes-Benz Superdome. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Minnesota Vikings and the New Orleans Saints. And he opts to not bring this one out. The first drive will start at the 25. For Phillip Lindsay, and he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
This defense is a difficult one to prepare for, one of the best in the league. They'll come at you from all angles, and they did a nice job there stopping him for a loss.
On second down, a run with Lindsay. That's what they needed. It's an 8-yard gain, and now third and 4 suddenly doesn't look so bad.
You've got to give kudos to your offensive line and the guy carrying the ball, because they were in a second and long situation. It seemed pretty dire, but they brought it back to third and manageable with that run.
Fights through and now a crease. He's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. That goes for a gain of 31. That's how you draw up the run-pass option right there. You get a chunk play out of it.
And you know quarterbacks love to throw the RPOs because oftentimes they're in-breaking routes, but receivers love it even more. The ball gets to them quickly, allows them to put some moves on in the secondary.
Now Cousins here on the bootleg. And the coverage terrific there as that's knocked out and incomplete. Antonio Brown, the intended receiver. But it's going to be second down.
And that's a nice job there, because you've got to play the ball, not the man when in coverage. That'll keep you away from a lot of needless penalties. And he's able to knock that one away.
On second down now, it's Lindsay. And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25. It's a first down on a gain of 10. Relatively small sample size, but that's his longest run of the first quarter. Bounced it out to the outside to make it successful.
And to get there, you actually need some help. It's not just your pure speed getting to the corner, making sure that the blocking is taken care of inside so the pursuit doesn't get you. And oftentimes, those wide receivers, tight ends that might be flexed out, they've got to control the edge and make sure no one from the outside can spoil the play before he gets there.
And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8. Gainer that time. This one goes for 19 yards.
I like the screen being called here early in the game, especially on the opening drive, because, Brandon, when guys come out of the locker room, especially those pass rushers, they are so amped up to get to the quarterback that you can use that against them, and a screen pass is a great way of doing it. A lot of teams against good pass rushing teams, they want to run the screen 10 to 12 times in the game.
And he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. Only a yard that time, second and goal. Defensively, pretty good start there with their backs against the wall.
That's a win for the stop troops right there. And if I'm them, I get a little bolder now. They won the first battle. Keep coming after them. Put the pressure on them.
The line of scrimmage, the 7 now on second and goal. They'll run here with with Lindsey. And they'll get this from the 8 to the 5. Pickup of 3. Driven it down the field nicely here on the opening drive, and now it's put up or shut up.
No doubt about it, because to make that type of a drive and ultimately kick a field goal would feel very disappointing. But I'm just wondering, is the head coach thinking, is this 4-down territory? Might he go for it?
From the 5, 3rd and goal. Touchdown, the New Orleans Saints put 6 up on the board. Looking sharp on that first drive. These guys, of course, coming off back-to-back victories. And you see that kind of advancing into this game, don't you?
You certainly do. And when you have a team that doesn't get too full of itself, even though they've won 2 games in a row, you get the end result that we saw there, that nice opening drive, because they're sharp, they're focused, and they're locked into everything that they're doing.
And a fair catch signal for and take it successfully.
The Vikings take over 1st and 10. Their own 25-yard line.
Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. And he's got his man in stride, complete. And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39. First play of the drive going for 14 and a first down.
First down.
On play action, they'll throw. He's got it complete to Diggs, right side. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up 2nd down.
Defensively here, you're facing a top 5 team in terms of points scored in the NFL, so when they're that high.
And the Saints pressure gets him. Brought down for a sack. Carlos Dunlap in there to get him, and that is sack number 6 now for him on the year. And he fires one that's intercepted. Levi Wallace with a pick, and the return stops at the 39-yard line. He had a little bit of the turnover bug last week, 3 interceptions. Not an absolute disaster, but another one here. Do you start to get a little worried?
You worry about your team as a whole, because you have to find a way to make those interceptions, quote-unquote, go away. And that means your defense. They've got to go out there on sudden change and at least hold people to field goals. And if that keeps happening, they lose confidence in the quarterback, and then no one plays well.
And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. He'll get 15 and a Saints first down.
At the 24-yard line.
Here's Lindsey. They'll get him to the ground at the 20 following a pickup of 4.
Ronnie Harris.
The Vikings and Saints, you might recall, they battled in the wild card round a season ago, and it was the guys in purple who came in and pulled off the upset with Kirk Cousins finding Kyle Rudolph in the end zone in overtime to sew up a 26-20 win. The run got 4. Now they deal with a 2nd and 6. Now it's Lindsey. And he'll take this inside the 20 and down to the 18. 3 yards is half of what they needed. Now can they get the other 3 here on 3rd down? Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
On 3rd down, here's Lindsey. And he's going to be taken down here, still a couple yards short of the first. After 1, 7-0 on EA Sports.
7, Vikings nothing.
And no field goal try here from the red zone. Offense out there. They'll go for it on 4th. From the shotgun, it's Cousins. And that is going to be incomplete. The Saints' decision to go for it backfires. And the Vikings' defense is going to get the football back. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. They had the interception last time. It led to the opening touchdown. So now 7-0 the score as they start first and 10. Now it's Kamara in the passing game. And way up past the 35 before he's taken down. 23 yards, the final tally.
It's a gain of 23 yards.
Here's a play fake as they set up to throw.
First down.
Escaping the pressure right. And he whips that one incomplete there. He was trying to get it to his running back, Alvin Kamara. And that'll bring up second down.
Second and 10.
This is Alvin Kamara, pro bowler in all three of his NFL seasons. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a 3rd and 8 coming up. Pretty good little two-play sequence there. You force the incompletion, then a very short pickup.
Yeah, now maybe you bring in an extra defensive back or two because you want to try and defend on 3rd down. They like to play those nickel or sub packages, don't they?
Foles. He completes it right side of the lane. A big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40.
James White.
Great way to convert on 3rd down there. 21 yards the play. Here's Foles. It's caught left side by John Brown. That catch good for only a couple.
Well, if you do read man coverage, Brandon, the drag route's a pretty good one to run against it because you're running away from people on it.
To throw again on 2nd down. Foles. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on 3rd down.
Normally you think the tight end's going to be able to catch the football and handle that contact. But in this case, maybe a little too much target to hit. That one was timed well. Incomplete.
Now Foles. And the defense has it covered. It's intercepted. Picked off by J.C. Jackson. And a terrific return as he'll take it up past the 35.
So that's back-to-back drives where they're throwing an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
Start the drive, but that one incomplete.
I have to give some credit to the defender on that when he read all of his keys perfectly and got a great break on the ball and able to force that incompletion.
A 2nd down throw for Cousins. He goes right back to Metcalf, this time complete. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. It's a pickup of 17 and a 1st down.
At the 46-yard line.
Cousins. This one into the hands of Metcalf. Touchdown, New Orleans. DK Metcalf hitting double digits with his 10th touchdown of the season. And the Saints now add 6 to their lead. And he knocks it through.
Makes the score Saints 14. Vikings.
So after the touchdown, Martin now on to kick this one away. Turn on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
The Vikings take over 1st and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
That's the reason we
here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. To this point, the results have not been good. 2 possessions, 2 turnovers.
And that's obviously something that can't continue, but to go a little bit deeper on that one, I would think about some play calls now, not even necessarily to my best player, but to someone I can trust with the ball. Try and get things settled down a little bit.
31-yard line.
A play action fake. They'll look to throw. Man, and he hits him in stride. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. 22 yards there, a 1st down. If you're going to blitz, likely going to leave you in man coverage with this guy, and that is less than ideal.
It is, because just about any offense that has an elite receiver, if you blitz and have him in man coverage, you're going to him, even if he has an elite defender on him, because he usually knows where the ball is before the defender does.
Flushed out right. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down.
This defense has been very disruptive early on as they force another one to go awry.
Seems to be the front and the back end pass rush. They've been able to get home, and they're taking the ball away in coverage as well.
I love how you put it together. The front and back working in sync.
And they're going to get him. He's taken down for a sack. Back at the 47-yard line. Carlos Dunlap. He's the one to get him, and that is sack number 7 for him on the year. Flush to his right. And for the third time here, this half, it's intercepted. Picked off near the 34. And they have the football and will set up shop at the 33-yard line. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33.
At their own 33-yard line.
They'll start on the ground with Lindsey, and he'll be taken down right around the 34 after a pickup of only a yard.
4-yard line.
You know, it's not just all athleticism from defensive linemen. Let's give them a little credit for their football intelligence as well. Read and react by them, understood the play call, and stacked it up and stuffed the run.
2 minutes to play, first half. It's 14-0. Coming up at halftime, I'll go from one personality, that's you, Charles Davis, to another one in Orlando, the coach. He'll have stats and scores from around the NFL. You and Jonathan Coachman, both larger than life.
No doubt about it.
But you're stuck with me in this booth,
yes,
and he's miles away and smiling.
And happy.
An extra defender in the secondary for the Vikings here on third down. Working out of the gun, Cousins. And he's got his man, that's Landry. And he is going to have a Saints first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. It'll be a Saints first down on a gain of 16 yards. And he'll get this into enemy territory, but not by much as he's down to the 48. Credit him with a 1-yard gain there to make it second and 9.
He's up second and 9.
From the gun, here's Cousins. And this is going to be caught, but they'll say out of bounds. So it's incomplete.
You and I watched film yesterday, and you told me to watch his feet. Well, for whatever reason, his footwork just looked off on that throw.
And you always love it when an ex-defensive back talks quarterback mechanics, right?
Well, but you're good at it.
Well, I try, all right? I don't know how good I am, but it doesn't take much to tell. His mechanics are off a little bit, exactly what you described. Footwork, that led to the incompletion. Explain when they get together to watch the game film, isn't it? I mean, they had the right call, had the out route. He's got to know where the first down sticks are, yet he steps out of bounds that close. Not their best play.
Feeling like they're not quite in field goal range yet, they're going to go for it on fourth. To throw his Cousins. He's just going to dump this one off to his fullback out of the backfield. All the way inside the 15 before they drop it. A gain of 26 and a conversion there as well on fourth down.
Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line.
They'll run. It's Lindsey. And this play goes nowhere. Losing yardage back to the 15. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime. Maybe just a slight detour on what's been a strong drive. Here's second and 11. Cousins to throw it. Screen pass to Lindsey. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. Ninth play of the drive now on third and a country mile. On third down, they're going to go with the option. Here's a quick throw out left. It's complete. And with just 1 second remaining in the first half, they'll call the timeout. So with 1 second left in the half, on is the field goal unit. From the left hash, this from 37. And it bangs off the right, upright, no good. So we come upon halftime with our score 14 to nothing. As we send you on over to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman in our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Coach. The Vikings set to receive the second half kickoff, and they trail it here as we resume play. Vikings now to start their next drive. They come out here with a zero on the scoreboard. What was said in that locker room? That's what I want to know.
I would love to have been in there because...
And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked up by J.C. Jackson. That one is going to sting. First play of the third quarter and a turnover.
And you have to know that at halftime, they spent a lot of time going through their checklist of what they wanted to accomplish to start this third quarter. Turning it over like this was not on that list.
Not at all. You come out of the locker room trailing, so that first drive to establish momentum is very key.
Crucial.
On first and 10, it's Lindsey. That one good for 10 yards. And it'll be second and very short.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
Another run by Lindsey. He's got a first down and much more inside the 20. And finally taken down at the 4-yard line. First.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
And he takes it across and into the end zone. Touchdown, Saints. Phillip Lindsey, his sixth touchdown of the season. And the forced turnover on defense leads to 6 points. And it's up and good.
Score, Saints 21, Vikings nothing. Sam Martin set to kick off.
Here's Martin now following the score as he'll send this one away.
Made at the 25-yard line. The Vikings take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Vikings now to start their next drive. Now they've sort of lost their way, partner. How do they recalibrate and get this proverbial train back on track?
Well, this is where leadership really comes into play. How's the head coach handling it? The offensive coordinator? Sometimes they just make a joke. All right, guys, you had your fun? All right.
Throwing out the window.
Yeah, let's get back on track here. And sometimes that'll work just fine.
I guess it's time now to lean on that leadership. On second and 10, Foles. Going deep for Diggs. And that's caught inside the 30. Touchdown, Vikings. Stephon Diggs hitting double digits with his 10th touchdown of the season. And the Vikings are able to close the gap just a bit. It's up, it's good, and that'll cut the lead to 21-7.
21, Vikings 7.
Folk now set to boot it after his guys put 6 on the board. Takes this about 5 yards deep. And this will not be returned. It'll come out to the 25.
Their own 25-yard line.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. Their lead down to two scores after the touchdown a moment ago as they start with a first and 10. The drive will commence with a run by Lindsey, and he'll wind up with about six, up past the 30 to the 31.
On the tackle.
Well, I think after that run, the defense get back in the huddle and looking at each other and maybe starting to question their confidence a bit. They gave up a significant run, 6 yards, and now you're saying to yourself, how do we stop them, and do I have enough confidence to make a play?
They'll go again with Lindsey, and he'll slip his way up across the 30 to the 32. It'll be a pickup of a couple, and it leaves him with a 3rd and 3.
Now, that's a mountain of a man that just made that stop, isn't it? But he's more than that. This guy's nimble and quick. More than a space eater, he just made a great play there.
Try and run for it with Lindsey, and he will have a first down as they get into the ground at the 37. Just 4 yards on the pickup, but that's good enough to extend the drive.
First and 10 at the 37-yard line.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on. Winds up a pickup of 2, maybe 2.5 to about the 39.
He's brought down at the 39.
A nice play design there with the touch pass. Looked good at the start, but bottom line, the defense was ready.
And they did a nice job scouting, didn't they? Not just scouting, but now executing once they saw the play for real after having worked on it all week in practice. They drilled on the play, then they drilled him.
On second down, it's Lindsey. A gain of a couple, and that's going to leave them with a 3rd and about 5.
They did a really nice job there defensively. They strung the play out, didn't give them a cutback lane. On each play, you have guys what I call our BCR players. Guys are responsible for the bootleg, for the cutback, and for the reverse. They played that one perfectly.
And rode him right out of bounds. And on 3rd down, a nickel formation here defensively. Now Cousins. He gets it to Brown. Good play. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. Brown, his first catch. It's a first down.
So he turned to a trusted, familiar face in that 3rd down situation. It paid off.
Yeah, you go to your veteran receiver in that spot, so you can't underestimate him when he's on the field defensively. Make sure you know where he is because he understands how to get open in key situations.
Cousins now to throw on 1st down. The Vikings after him, and they get there for the sack. Ochenna Nwosu, he's the one to get him, and that is sack number 7 for him on the year. After the sack, it's 2nd and 19, and the road gets a bit tougher from here. Another try after the 1st down sack. Cousins throwing the out route incomplete. It's Brown. A 14-yard gain there as they look to improve this 14-point lead.
And that was yardage that they needed there after the sack on 1st down. They didn't get all of it back, but now they look at 3rd down as a manageable situation, one that they have a much better chance of picking up.
Cousins. They'll complete this to Ingram as tight end. And this effort won't be enough as they rally up to stop him a couple of yards short. They stop him for only 3 that time, and that'll bring up 4th down. So out comes the field goal team now for the 2nd time here today. On the left hash, this from 48 yards. And this will split the uprights. It's right down the middle.
And they will open things up a bit more. It's 24-7. So he missed that field goal earlier, but he says not this time. Able to knock it through, give his guys three.
I like his poise. I like his confidence, his belief in himself. Sometimes when you miss that first one, you see a lot of guys sag and they can't make the next one. Not in this case. Stepped right up like a pro.
Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit, maybe pump up the pace, maybe go 2 minutes. Who knows? We'll see what they decide to do.
And incomplete as he was knocked as he threw it, and it took the ball off course. Glad to be in the great city of New Orleans, rolling along here in the third quarter, 2nd and 10. He'll let one go deep for Howard. And my goodness, another interception. Picked off at the 40. Yet another interception, and I just had to double-check my math. But it is now 8 between last week and this week.
Well, I just used a calculator. I didn't worry about double-checking it. But the thing that always throws me when you see quarterbacks in this type of a bad spot, they're trying to figure out what they can do to change it, and sometimes they try too hard, and they never get out of it. And that's where he is right now. He's just locked in a really bad way.
Here's a throw out wide complete to his running back right side. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. They may want to go back to that one. First play of the drive, good for 15 and a first down.
First and 10 at the 46-yard line.
One quarter remains here in week 16. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. First down. Here's Cousins. Takeaway, but that's just step one. They still have a lot of work to do.
But they don't want to focus on that now. Now it's about getting the ball in the end zone and hoping they can take it away again.
Yeah, still a 3-score game, though, fourth quarter. And opening there on that first down run as he gets his forward for about 8 or 9. That looks to be 8 officially, so 2nd and 2. They stay on the ground with White. Defensively, you said coming in earlier in the broadcast, the magic number was 20 points for you. That's what you thought they would have to hold this offense to, or less than that. And wow, they've done that in a big way, haven't they?
Not only have they done it, they put themselves in a great position to win this one because holding them down was paramount. If they could get it done, but guess what? We see the end result. Right now, they have their eye on victory.
They're leading here in the fourth. Looking to throw again on 2nd down. Foles. And he'll be hit as he releases it. And that'll fall incomplete.
That incompletion is not a surprise with the way that this one has gone. And the frustration of body language is evident everywhere. This team, they've really been put through the ringer in this one.
On 3rd down, he'll drop to throw. And Pascal's got it. Zach Pascal, his 4th touchdown on the year. And the Vikings are able to cut into that deficit.
You've got to understand situational football because they're playing with the lead here late in the ballgame. So the back defender has got to be as deep as the deepest receiver. Keep everything in front of you, rally up and make the play.
Yeah, you would think they have the 3-score lead. Now it's down to 2, but 3-score lead here late. But they wouldn't give up a big pass play like that, but they did.
Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. Well, don't look now, but they've got a little bit of a battle on their hands again. Back to a 2-score game, the interception that led to a touchdown. You'd have to think they're a little more careful here if they do indeed try to throw the football.
Yeah, and I was a little surprised by the last throw. You know, that type of throw in this type of a game, I'm going to be very careful about it. Maybe the only throw you make is maybe a toss to your halfback or something like that. Otherwise, take care of the thing and finish this bad boy off.
So now they have to contend with second and 13 after the first down run goes backwards. Now a carry for Lindsey. And he's able to plow forward up to about the 29, just shy of the 30. It's a 7-yard pickup. They'll be looking now to 3rd and 6.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
Screen, it's complete, and he will have the first down, but he winds up taking a pretty good shot that time.
That's good.
Call it a gain of 7, and it gets him a new set of downs. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on 1st and 10. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground, and he's taken down right at the 45-yard line. First, good for 20 and a first down.
Well, that's a carry they have to be satisfied with. And throughout this game, they've been satisfied with what he's given them. Whenever they've needed a big run, a first down, he's the guy they've turned to. And it doesn't matter what the defense thinks. They think they've got the confidence to keep handing it to him and keep picking up good yardage.
Another nice gain, 16 yards there and a first down again. Here's a give to Lindsey. Oh, no, he lost the football. And the Vikings pick up the football. And they will take over at the 29-yard line.
Partner, that one looked like it was over. I mean, they had control, had the football, and the defense had to make a play in order to keep them in the game. That's exactly what they did.
And now that door ajar, 2-score game. So hold on here, not done in the fourth. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. They trail by 2 scores in the fourth, and their defense did its job getting the fumble recovery. Time to see what this offense has left in the tank. Here's a throw, complete right side to start things out. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. Give him 13 yards on the opening play of the drive and also give him a first down.
First down, Viking.
Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. He's got it complete to Diggs right side. And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. They'll contain him to just 4. Second down. 2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So the Vikings in possession of the football as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Throwing again on second down. Falls. Quick hitter here. It's complete. And he'll go down inside the 45 before going out of bounds. It's a first down on a gain of 10. And he's top 5 in the league in terms of receiving yardage because of plays like that. What have you seen from him on film that you like so much?
Well, I'll strip away everything else and get to what we call the moment of truth. When the ball's arriving and there's a defender there, he just comes down with the ball. He competes and takes it away. Great hands, great ability to finish.
And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked by the rookie Julian Blackmon. 20, and he's flagging down the left side. It's a foot race, and he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. And that one will pretty much erase any hopes of a fourth quarter comeback.
With emphasis, interception, return for touchdown. Door closed, locked. Reinforced.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away.
Fair catch made at the 25-yard line. The Vikings take over 1st and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. They're down big here late. I don't know. You just one last drive here for pride.
Some people like to do that. I remember playing for a guy once. We were down huge, and someone said, "Coach, what do you want to call?" He just waved me in. I'm like, "Who cares? Let's get out of here
to do something some other time, but some teams like to do something at the end to feel a little bit better as they continue to move forward.
Yeah, probably just want to put this one behind them.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Foles. And it's going to be intercepted. Jamal Adams with it, the all-pro safety. And they will finally put it into return, but not until he takes it back all the way inside the 10-yard line. The number 7, usually lucky here for him. 7 picks he's thrown in this game. That's only happened 6 times since 1960.
And I know that the most recent time it happened, the guy who threw him, he won a Heisman Trophy in college. So sometimes you just have a lousy game. Doesn't necessarily mean it's a bad career. But when you're talking about 1 game, 7, you're right, not lucky at all.
Yeah, Ty Detmer, the last to do it in 2001 to throw 7 picks. Suddenly, it's first and goal after the interception. A quick change in the situation here. They'll run with Lindsey, and they'll lose yardage here. They go backwards to the 13-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of 6, and it'll set them back for second down.
Brings up second and goal at the 13-yard line.
Cousins here to throw. And he'll take it into the end zone for the Saints touchdown. DK Metcalf, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Saints take advantage of field position on the turnover to cash in for 6. Extra point right down the middle. And the lead is now 24.
Set to kick off.
So after the touchdown, Martin now on to kick this one away. Taken about 7 yards deep. And he'll be dropped at the 21-yard line. So bringing it out of the end zone proves not a good decision. Loses him about 4 yards.
At their own 21-yard line.
Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. Let's just be frank. They're playing for pride at this point.
that's all that's left, because victory, not a chance now. And I can't wait to see how they actually go about doing it, because there are a lot of people watching the body language of the guys on the field now, and if they call plays they want executed, they need to do that and do it really well. Otherwise, there could be repercussions.
We'll see how they handle the waning moments of this one. Here's Foles.
And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
We've talked about it, CD, but it bears repeating. They are struggling to throw the football. All the interceptions and more incompletions. It just doesn't look like things are in sync out there.
I would agree with that, and it's not a good day when you feel like an incomplete pass is almost a win for you because it wasn't intercepted. And I think the receivers now, when they're running their routes, they want to catch the ball, but they also want to make sure that the defenders don't take it away.
Now Foles. That's into the hands of Pascal. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. He's been a one-man wrecking crew these last couple of plays. This time 18 more and a first down. Back to throw again. A good throw here, finding Pascal. And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25. The Vikings going to use their third and final timeout as they'll stop it with 11 seconds remaining in the ball game. Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. Complete with just 6 seconds left on the clock.
Incomplete. He was covered by Jamal Adams.
Once again, they'll come up on the 26-yard line, second and 10. He's going to let it go deep for the end zone. And this will be incomplete. 1 second left to go.
Incomplete. It's third down.
This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have them looking at third and 10. One final shot. They'll look to throw. And it will be incomplete. As time has run.